But since on that day we were discussing about cyber security, okay, I need to okay, let me open it. There are a few interesting websites which you can check. First of all, about hacking. You do not know whether your account has been hacked or not. So to check that, there is a good website. It is called as Have I Been Pwned? This is, it allows you to search across multiple data breaches to see if your email address has been compromised. So you can simply click on the website and just enter your email address here. So this is that link. So we can try it. Anybody can type your email ID into the chat box. And we can just test it here in live. Say, for example, if I want to see my email ID, please don't send message on it. This is the ID I have just created for these useless things of creating an account in some website for that. not my communicational address it is, but you put your email ID into it and then click on, you just check. Oh no, it has found in one data breach and found no pastes subscribe to service. So it means that this account is safe. Otherwise, it will show you all these things wherever in the databases or things it goes into it. So that you can check. The another one very interesting thing, and I had published an article on it also. This is related to your mobile phone, particularly since I have an Android phone only. I'm not sure about the iPhone application, but Android, Google allows you to find your device. And see, this is quite interesting that this is my phone. And what I will do, I'll simply type in Google, find my device. So here, this is find my device. And here it is already showing me my phone number, the name of the company. It is Redmi 4, and it says that last synced was 23rd of March. This is in real time. It is happening now, and you can go on this website, find my device. So it is now contacting. Say here, and see it has activated. And just wait. Means automatically it is trying to connect with the device. It is a Xiaomi Redmi 4. And as soon as it traces it, it will show wherever on earth this device is currently presented. So looks like, okay, here it comes. See, now if you see very clearly, the battery icon is 67% in my phone, which is there on the website also. It has identified. Apoor is our home network. So it has identified that on which network I'm connected. And its location, it is showing me that here, this green button. So if you can see, you can. Okay. Others can't hear you. Change microphone. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Okay, because it on the screen it is showing me that the participants cannot hear me. But anyway, here you can see that it is showing me the location and other things. And then the good point is that if I click on this play sound, the device will ring for 5 minutes. Even if somebody has put it on silent, means completely if switched off, then it's a different matter. And then you can secure. And sometimes if your phone is lost, you can't recover it, then at least you can erase your data remotely from here. So that is a good thing about it. Another device application on that day I was telling you is Lenscap. So this is Lenscap to disable the camera. You can install it, and once you activate it, then it can switch off your camera. So otherwise, if somebody gets into your phone, they can remotely activate the camera, and you know the things they can go something strange from there. Then another thing on that day I was telling that on your phone, you can try it right now with me. Just open your dial pad in the phone, and if you can type star *21#, and means dial this number, it will show you if call forwarding is enabled on your phone or not. Means when you receive any call with somebody listening to it or not. That way it will show it to you. And there is another command, which is *#62#, and that way it will give you more details about the features which are how your phone is behaving. And if you find that the call forwarding is activated on that, you can do one thing. Just you can dial this code *#002 and *#, and then it will disable the forwarding of the app for there. So that goes with it. Okay, so this is about them. And then I would like to share something like as Dr. Binu told you. I divide the media, the content on online teaching learning into 5 categories. Whatever the content you have, my own classification, I divide them into narrative media. Narrative media means like podcast.com, where you use some kind of narration. The second is interactive media, in which the participants, they will interact with you. For example, H5P, I'll show you some of the examples of that. Then communication media means like social networks or Moodle forum, Moodle discussion forums. Here, this is the communicative media. Then adaptive media, where the things you take, say, like for example, simulations. And then one is the productive media. Productive media is something like you have your wiki or your blog on which you create something else on your own from there. So let us see some of the examples of that. And first of all, Dr. Binu has told you wonderful tools like Mentimeter, Padlet, and those things. I have also been using them from there. And perhaps you may be using them. This is a good website of no download, no nothing, no payment, no download. It is written here. Simply go to this website and start recording. It is something like Screencastify or Loom or etc. you have used. or screencast-o-matic, which gives you a good recording, but 15 minutes and watermark is placed there. But here it is simple, it is 100% free, flexible recording, and you can use. So there are only these three steps. You see how it is to be used. Just simply go to this, click on the start recording button, then check your audio device, video device, etc., and stop. And after that, just download it. And in, if you want to edit using this one, that it allows you to edit that also. So there, this is a website called as recordcast.com. Here is the chat box. Here is the chat box. Okay. So let me close this one. And here is that one. Okay. This I have shown it to you. So another one is the site which I am regularly using is called as the Idea Boards. Again, this is, if you want to create your login, you can create your login, but it is not compulsory. To create it, it is a good idea, and it is super simple to use. It runs on your various browsers. You can see it here. And simply to create it, how to create your own board. So name, say for example, we can see vaccination and description. The vaccination for COVID. Is good. Okay. Or not. And then we can have two sections, one in favor of it, another like vaccination is good and vaccination is not good. This current one. Then it is asking you, are you a robot? If you are a robot, then tell the computer that yes, you are a robot, and click on create. And that's how it is super simple to use it. Now you share this link with your audience. And here I have pasted the link in the chat box. Simply click. You can use it your computer or your mobile device. It will work. You see here, there are this green button with a positive. When you click on it, it will open, create a sticky note, and you just type and click outside anywhere. That's the as simple as one. So try it. And once you your answer starts appearing, you can export them as the PDF or Excel or depending on what. Then you can view all sections. You can sort it by the time it was created or the number of responses, how it is there. Yeah. So this side, it is those who are in favor of it, and on the right, those who are not in favor of it. So somebody can click on this one also, then you will see the color will be different of your sticky note. And that way, another interesting thing here is that you see this plus zero at the bottom of it. So if you click on it, you will upvote it, means like thumbs up and update it. So it is here plus one. And that way it is something like you like on Instagram, you like on Facebook, to upvote it, to support that answer, something like that. And say here in yes, already there are three yes. So that way you increase the count of that. And this is how, and it is random, means anonymous, unless you ask the participant that when you submit your answer, type your name also. Otherwise it remains anonymous. So the people, they can freely express their opinion about it. It is simply a idea boards to generate ideas on anything or something like that. And then once you think that it is over, then you can click on it and click on PDF. I'm not sure you will be able to see this because it has opened a new window on my screen. And then it saves it as a PDF in which it will show me this data that goes with it. Okay, so this is how you use these facilities as discussing something. Padlet, Mentimeter, these things, they are as a way of a discussion media. Then adaptive media, there are good side. I am not sure if somebody has already tried it or not, but this is a wonderful website called as FAT Simulations, and the best part is that they are open source, so you can use them and see physics, chemistry, mathematics, earth science, biology, on various subjects. These are available to you. You can simply go somewhere select any tool, and then you can use them. Say, for example, let us, and this five, you see the five here, five means HTML5. This is HTML5. See, all these are made created using HTML5. So suppose you want to use this balancing act, and here you see this green icon on the right. What is this icon for?
Google Classroom.
Yes, Google Classroom. Perfect answer, Gajananji. Thank you. This is Google Classroom. So good point is that if you like this activity to be shared with your students, simply click this one. Simply click it, and it will open another window on your screen in which it will ask you. I think you are not seeing it, so let me check. Share. Okay. Firefox, there are showing two windows. Which one will go? Do you see a small window of Google Classroom? No?
No, sir. We see a blank screen.
Yeah, because I need to share my screen. Let me see. And here now you will see it. You see this share to classroom, it has come.
Yes, sir. Now we can see it.
Okay. So you choose the class, in the class in which you want to put it. Say, for example, Srikakulam, it has come here, and I want to add it as what? As an assignment, as a question, as a material, or what? Okay, say as a material, and go. Simply it will go, it will ask me type. So balancing act, and then its description, here it is, and then I will simply click on post. So it has been posted to your class. If you want to see it, you can view it. So that way, and otherwise it is very easy. You can download it, you can embed it. Embedding means you can embed it in your learning management system. So like if you are using Moodle, that can go as an embedding tool into it. And here, these are the activities. You can select anything like game. So you can click on it and select which level you would like to go. So here it is showing you to balancing to be shown to the student. So you need to, pick it up and then say, no, wrong, try again. This time you picked it and shift it somewhere and check. So this is interactive in nature. And the website of NCERT, I showed it to you, that was also using H5P, something similar kind of things, but here it is more interactive in nature. There you need to click on in something, and then its chain reaction will happen using that. So these are the FAT simulations. You can use them for it. So here is the link. You can find, means it has a lot of applications which you can try for your course material or for your subject. Those of you who are teaching mathematics, there is a good website for that. That is called as mathspad.co.uk. It is also interactive. Okay, it has come here. Let me close this shorter windows and see here. This is interactive tools. I like this much, very much. You can give your students to it. Say, for example, I will select a pen and I want to write anything I wrote it. Then if you want to click clear, you click and you select it here, then it will be straight line. Using this one without it, it will be your free hand. Whatever you want to write, you write it using free hand. But selecting this, if you want to type, it will be a straight line. Then selecting this palette, you select the color of your pencil in what way you want. And these are my favorite ones. Say, for example, you select the scale and see here exactly to what point you can ask the students to draw a straight line. That goes. And you can use this one. And if you want, you can have a degree angle by clicking on it. And then simply here, by connecting that, so it will give you the triangle. There is another interesting thing here is this one. This is a great thing. You want to draw a circle, so you select it and then decide your radius, how much you want it, and then lock it, and after that simply rotate it. So that way you want to change the color of the pencil, okay, unlock it, adjust the diameter or radius and simultaneously click on it. So that way you go it. So these are the length means thickness. You see the thickness, it has increased. That way it goes. So these are, so this is the website mathspat.co.uk. You can try various things, the construction transformation tools, etc., etc. There are a few things which are easily available to you. So I have shared you the link of that with you. Let me show you one last thing because my another workshop is going to be start. This is called as Genially. It is a very interactive website. You call it as, and you need to create genially.com. So you can see a tool to create interactive content that makes your audience fall in love, communicate, educate, attract by bringing content to life. So this is the website, genially.com. You need to create your ID on it to use it. And this is wonderful, a website, means it's very, very interactive. Create your free account on it. Once you create it, this is an example, say a trip to Cambridge. So you, this is the assignment. And here, the task given to the students is reading task. Read the text and find three things you would like to do in Cambridge. So here, this is the task. You can, as Dr. Binu was showing you, the QR code, you scan it, or there it will take you to this web page. If you click on it, it will take you to that website. Here, 11 best things to do in Cambridge. So here, 11 best things to do in Kerala. That way you can have that page into it. After that, then tell your students that use this notepad to make a note. So you click on this notepad and then another page will open. This is Telegraph. That's, and here you can type your text. So here you can say, I went to meet Dr. Binu at Kuttikanam. I hope this spelling is okay, which is a beautiful place, like that. Okay. And just you click on publish, it will be published, saved. Then come back, go to the next. The next task coming up for the student, it is, this time it is a research task. Find three places from the article on the map. So here it is, this map, and this map is live map, Google map. You can replace this map with anything. And it is asking you to click on something, say here new town or what, and then it will ask, it is asking you. So you can zoom in, zoom out, and after that, save a link of each place in your notes. So you go to your notes and save the links there, like that. After that, the student goes next. And this time it is a viewing task. Watch this video. And this video is, say, taken from YouTube, or you upload your own video. and this works. And are there any places you want to like? So this is there, and then further next. So you see a lot of interactivity here. It is weather. Find out weather in the campus for the next 3 days and add to your notes. So this is another application which the students will come to know, that time and date, how to find the temperature, date, time, anything about any place from there.